Got a deadly brother on the line here supporting a good cause. Your band again, Joel O'Connor, and your band Andorra, isn't it? Welcome to Radio Skid Row again, bub.
Thank you. Always lovely to be on.
Now, I was listening to this song called I Believe, and it's about this Nigerian sister named Ella.
That's right.
Well, can you tell us a bit about that information, because I'm trying to look it up?
So I got in contact with this Nigerian R&B singer who's based in Lagos, Nigeria, last year, after I put the word out to my friends. I said, I want some positivity here. You know, the world's pretty kind of low at the moment. So could you tell me how you finish this sentence? There is hope because. And I got a bunch of my friends to send in their answers to that question. And I thought, wow, this is amazing. What could I do with it? So I sat down and I started working it into a song. And then when I was chatting to Ella, she's wanting to do some music projects as well. And I said, what if we recorded this song together? You get a band together in Lagos and we record it and we do something positive with it. So she said, that's a great idea. You know, there's a whole lot of orphanages around Nigeria, and you know, people might find it hard to believe, but there's actually 20 million orphans in Nigeria. That's pretty much the whole population of Australia. So
yeah.
Kids without parents, you know, so it's full on. So she said, yeah, you know, let's reach out to some local orphanages here and we'll get people to listen to this song, and when they like it, you know, we'll set up a GoFundMe and we'll try and get some things together to help these kids. So we've been buying food and books and medicine supplies and stuff for people that have been listening to the song and then going to the GoFundMe and putting something towards it. And, you know, it really kind of speaks to the song, because it's such a beautiful song. It's so positive and uplifting, and we've been able to do something great with it.
That's absolutely deadly. And you've got a few more songs there as well, I've noticed, because I've only just... We'll play this one to go out to the mob. Any special request you'd like to say? It's called I Believe. Joel, shout out to anybody for this song, I Believe it's called. And yeah. Did you write this, or...?
Yeah, I wrote the song. So I wrote put the lyrics together and then developed the melody. So that's what I tend to do, because, you know, I sing, but I don't play an instrument, so I work out the melodic structure and then work with somebody to kind of put it together. So I sent a draft over to Nigeria and said, you know, I think this is where the horns would go here, this is where the guitar would do this.
Oh my goodness.
And Ella got her band together, and they managed to put the song together based on those ideas and, you know, make it happen.
Oh wow, Radio Skid Row.
Shout out to everybody out there, shout out to any orphans listening, anybody who's been an orphan, anybody out there, you know, who's done it tough and who's, you know, getting through life or got through life because, you know, they've maintained their strength and had a positive attitude.
I believe in the spirit of man and man. I believe in the spirit of humankind. I believe in the love that surrounds us, helping us rise up, shaping what we find. Every breath you take can be understood. Every breath you take can be a force for good. Every breath you take we can try.
Rise up, keep it a bay. Cause the side of your face just pulls me through.
I believe in the spirit.
that's just amazing. Like, you just, how long did it get to take you to do that?
Well, I put the ideas down, you know, in a couple of days, and then we probably worked on it over a couple of months. So, you know, getting a band together, doing some recordings in Lagos, sending it back, and, you know, working on some edits and stuff. So I think it probably took about 3 months to get to that point.
So you're the music arranger?
Yeah, I was sort of the director abroad, you know, going,
fantastic.
You know, tweak this bit here, that sounds fantastic, you know, and just kind of, you know, working it through until we got it absolutely perfectly the way we wanted.
Yeah, wow. And there's more songs in there which I didn't have a chance to, you know, to go through, but I may have to catch up with you. And you can, you know, let us know about them songs.
I'd love to.
That's our next little thing. Probably on Friday. If not Friday, we'll do it again on the Tuesday. So I can get used to your songs. And Andorra, which is your old band name, isn't it?
That's right. I put it under that name.
That's great. Because that's your band name anyway, from Rock the Block days.
That's right.
Reggae on the Block.
Yeah, it just kind of makes it easier to put, you know, the music all in one spot. So, you know, I'm sort of like one of those, guys that keeps the name because it's sort of connected with all the other music that's out there and the video clips and everything. I'm Melbourne-based and the other guys are still in Sydney. So, you know, when we do a reunion tour, we'll be able to bring Ella over and add that one to the show.
Yeah, that's awesome. Anyway, thank you so much. Now, this Blessed Child, what's the name? How did you get about to write this song?
Yeah, that's a funny one. A friend of mine in Wales told me one day that this little kid had been trying to help the dogs in the park by picking up all the glass. He didn't want the dogs to cut their feet. And he was a little kid, you know, maybe 4 or 5, and he cut his thumb. And he'd never seen a cut like that on himself, so he didn't know whether, you know, when you get some blood on your finger, whether that means you're going to die. And so he went up to a door, and he was really scared, and, you know, she took him in and put a band-aid on and gave him a cuddle. And I thought, you know, it was kind of beautiful in the sense that children can be so innocent that something like that, they don't know the gravity of it because they're still protected from the harshness of the world, but at the same time, you know, they want to do something beautiful and they've got heart like that and they go out and, you know, try and, you know, look after the puppy dogs and things. So I got inspired to write that song based on that and the innocence of children and how beautiful that is even in difficult situations like that. It shines.
Oh, wow. That's beautiful. Okay, we're going into the song. Thank you so much.
In his lunchbox. Blessed child, blessed child, clearing the playground to not hurt the dogs. Blessed child, blessed child, stigmata on his cologne. Blessed child, blessed child, for this lesson in love. In his small cuddy field, the free-falling heart betrayed faithful words. Her, a sense of adult dismay in his small cuddy field. Beauty dreams abandoned, jackknives and dogs limp. Blessed child, blessed child. Against a stranger's thigh. Blessed child, who pleads to know if he will die. Blessed child, as life's laceration stab out of hand. Blessed child, who now knows the suffering to be a man.
Blessed child, blessed child, blessed child, blessed child, blessed child.